In 1989, a major environmental disaster shook public confidence in corporate America, the Exxon Valdez oil spill. 10.8 million gallons of oil poured into Alaska's Prince William Sound, devastating one of the world's most pristine habitats. The Valdez spill placed a new and critical spotlight on the relationship between corporations and society. Suddenly, the environmental costs of doing business became painfully clear, and it was apparent that companies weren't doing enough to account for the environmental and social impacts of their operations. Just 6 months after the spill, a group of investors launched an organization to tackle this problem, a small nonprofit called Ceres.
The Ceres Project was founded on the belief that considering financial profits alone and investing in savings for our future can blind us to social and environmental costs that may in fact rob us of our ability to have a future.
Ceres began with a bold challenge. It called on companies to endorse what became known as the Ceres Principles, a 10-point code of corporate environmental conduct. In 1993, Sunoco became the first Fortune 500 company to formally adopt the principles and began working with Ceres to report and improve on its environmental performance.
The one thing that Ceres offered, the fact that we could begin to have a constructive dialogue, having people not associated with our business and explaining where they're coming from, it was extraordinarily beneficial to us.
The relationship with Sunoco ushered in a wave of commitments from other companies like Ford, Bank of America, and Timberland to engage with Ceres stakeholder teams to find sustainable solutions to their environmental and social challenges.
The way Ceres has pushed Timberland to think about stakeholder engagement is a round table. There's a social and business problem at the center of the table, and there's a creative way, if we listen to the activists, if we talk to the citizen, if the investor's voice is heard, if the business person's voice is heard, we can come up with a better solution.
Ceres promoted, created a form of stakeholder dialogue which was really not available anywhere else. Secondly, we embraced vigorously our identity as the leading proponent of standardized environmental reporting. And then the third thing was being a catalyst for change.
In 1997, building on its success with company sustainability reporting, Ceres launched the Global Reporting Initiative, GRI, with the United Nations Environment Program and the TELUS Institute, offering the first standardized platform for corporate reporting in the world.
We were one of the early companies in the United States to be reporting. We followed GRI all the way from its birth, I have to say, and supported it because we wanted a level playing field for reporting.
GRI is now the de facto international standard used by more than 1,500 companies for corporate reporting on environmental, social, and economic performance. But Ceres wasn't just concerned with companies reporting their performance, it was also pushing companies to improve.
In 96, we were emitting 3.25 pounds of CO2 per kilo of product. In 2006, it's down to 158, so it's a decrease of 51%. This tracking of emissions, we owe it to the Ceres system.
Throughout its history, Ceres has been pushing for corporate disclosure of environmental and social performance. But beyond voluntary disclosure, Ceres has been working to strengthen mandatory disclosure efforts as well. In March of 2009, Ceres persuaded the National Association of Insurance Commissioners to require all insurance companies to file annual reports on their risks from climate change, and also to report on what strategies they're using to manage those risks.
It's really a tremendously important step. First, it's the world's first mandatory climate risk disclosure requirement, so it sets an important precedent. And it ought to light a fire under the SEC to act. It also increases pressure on other industries like oil and gas or electric power, or the automotive industry that also face substantial risk from climate change to improve their disclosure.
Investors too have become increasingly aware of the costs of poor environmental and social performance in their portfolios, especially the hidden costs from global warming pollution. And Ceres has been working over the last 7 years to incorporate investor concerns into the sustainability dialogue to advance corporate performance.
The investment community was never a party at the table. They just weren't there. Ceres brought them in.
In 2003, Ceres made investor concerns about climate change a major focus, launching the Investor Network on Climate Risk at the United Nations. INCR is a group of institutional investors and financial firms who recognize the urgency for action on climate change and the enormous investment in job opportunities as renewable energy and other low-carbon technologies take hold globally. INCR has grown from 10 investors managing $600 billion in assets in 2003 to now more than 80 investors with nearly $7 trillion in assets. In 2008, Ceres organized the third UN Investor Summit on Climate Risk, the largest gathering ever of financial leaders focused on the common goal of tackling climate change.
This is the third summit that the United Nations has held. 3.5 years ago at the first one, the amount of money in the room was under $1 trillion. Today, it's $20 trillion. Clearly, this is a topic where there is critical mass and investors care.
Over the years, Ceres has achieved remarkable results by translating environmental problems into the language of the financial markets, a language of bottom-line risk and opportunity that corporations and investors understand and respond to. It's a revolutionary strategy, and the world has never needed it more.
Achieving a sustainable economy is within our reach. This is our moment. And our solutions are clear. We need to value companies based on their environmental and social performance, and we need honest accounting that factors in the true costs of pollution, such as energy efficiency and renewable power. We need smart government policies that spur clean solutions. At Ceres, our approach works. Our network offers tremendous leverage, and our vision for the future couldn't be more clear. I hope you'll join us to build a truly sustainable economy.